Yes, here we all are for our final evening of practice. Welcome, everyone. So we're going to have quite a simple evening again. I might say a few thoughts. And the first half will be period of reflection, meditation, but with a little bit of a Padmasambhava focus. So I'm going to be dropping in some very short bits of teachings from him while we're sitting. So not quite like a meditation. That's why I'm calling it reflection, because you'll be sitting quietly and I'll just say a few lines and then leave you to do whatever. And then after a little while, I'll say a few more lines. I noticed on the, what's it, Padlet. Who came up with that name, but I noticed on the Padlet that somebody posted a quote from the teaching of his, my brain is gone. What's the one where it's like the open awareness one. It's got lots of bits. So I'm going to be quoting a bit from that, but also from some of his advice to the three women, fortunate women, and I'm also a little bit from his advice for the treasure seekers. So it'll be a combination of coming from those three texts, but a lot of very good advice, some specifically around meditation, some just around practice and life. So because of that, let's start. Yeah, we'll start with a Padmasambhava mantra. We'll have that period of readings and reflection, and then we'll have another Padmasambhava mantra, then we'll have a leg stretch, and again a fairly traditional Sevenfold puja. But before that, I think Daiketu has some stuff he wanted to say.
Thank you, Bodhilila. I'm already spotlighted, great. I wanted to take a few minutes of your time. First, thanking Bodhilila and Paramananda. They have been very generous on sharing their knowledge with everyone. Even I'm checking also the videos, I'm learning new stuff. So it's always very, very interesting and also very helpful and inspiring on being on these retreats as someone who can learn something. We can always learn something. But also it's a pleasure for me to be here as part of the Buddhist Center online. So I also wanted to thank the whole team at Dharmachakra. That's the name of our team. So for example, Chandradasa has been your host in many of the sessions. Also Zach has been around. And also, of course, the dev team that help us put all the technical items so that we can create the website. And there's a lot of things going around on these events. So I wanted also to thank the whole team. And also, especially, I wanted to thank Upeksha Priya for heroically stepping on the last minute to host all the pujas, going to London and then connecting all the cables, all everything around, and also being your host in the evening sessions. He has been a very a wonderful team member also, and also because Sangadhar unfortunately had a family emergency, so he had to come here to Mexico to attend some family concerns. So that's why Upeksha Priya was here with us. So thank you very much, Upeksha Priya. And also I wanted to thank you for being here. Without you, of course, it's very important that you're here, because without you, these events simply would not exist. It's always for me very inspiring on being here in these events, seeing people from around the world. I mean, I can see someone from Vancouver, someone from Spain, I saw someone from New Zealand around there. Yes, exactly. So I'm here also from Mexico City. So basically, as you can see, this is part of like an international Sangha. So of course, the in-person activities are very important, and we're not trying to kind of substitute that, but in a way to augment what we can do also by providing these virtual spaces so that we can have more content, an additional experience that we can share with other people. Maybe it would be very difficult for me to share with you if it's not for these kind of online spaces. So I also just wanted to thank to you. And also, very important, this Dharmachakra is always giving these kind of events without any, let's say, something that you have to pay upfront. It's based on Dana, basically. So whenever you book any event, you have two options, either to donate or to just book without any Dana and then proceed. So we do it like that. We started doing this event since the pandemic, so they have been quite successful in a way, because lots of people are joining and also benefiting from this. That's why we are doing that, so that we can share the knowledge of teachers like Bodhilila and Paramananda. So if you can support us, every little counts. I know that most of you have already supported us, but if you can consider supporting us, if you have not done, I will put a link right now on the chat. Just be sure to select the event in there. And basically this support supports the platform and also supports the teachers, the Dharma teachers, so that they can continue this. Well, basically this is out of love. So they can continue on doing this, not only on these events, but also on their Buddhist centers. So that's all I wanted to say. Thank you. Actually seeing you here really inspires me on my work. That the work that we do is it has some usefulness. It's inspiring people, it's inspiring me. So it's not just like putting somewhere on social media or creating something, it has an effect. So that's an inspiration for me personally. So I wanted to thank everyone, and well, thanks for being here. See you hopefully on our next events. And well, without further ado, I'm going to pass it on back to Bodhilila. Thank you.
And thank you very much, Daiketu. And I think how generous of you to be back at work and hosting this retreat when you've only just got ordained. And it's also really exciting having you there with this energy, having just been ordained and not quite knowing who you are yet, because you're not David, you're Daiketu, and who knows who Daiketu is going to become. So it's just really lovely to have that coming into our retreat. And again, yes, well, I've got a lot of personal thanks to Peksha Priya, because I've been having all these, I've been in device dukkha, and he's been trying to help me out and sort things out and being very, very patient with me, not understanding why things don't work and things, and trying to talk me through it will help out. But also all of you, because, you know, as Kater was saying, well, without you, this event wouldn't be happening. But it's more than that. It's that together, by coming along and practicing and everybody attending to it in their own way, we've co-created this really lovely community that's made it possible to go to depth, I think, for probably a lot of us, and that has felt kind of a safe enough place to practice and for things to come up if they need to come up, and yeah, get a real sense of, you know, from the questions and the things people have been sharing. But also just, you know, showing up for those really long mantra periods in the afternoons and showing up for the evenings and not just coming along for the talks or whatever. We've created a real community of practice. And that's the thing about when we meditate together, we're supported by the other people, you know, who are practicing alongside us. And even if we're not in the same room where we can really feel that energy, there's something about, even with this virtual space, you can still feel connected and you can still feel supported by the other people on the retreat. Particularly seeing those sort of familiar faces coming back again, not everybody the same in every single session, but that recurring, I was going to say refrain, it may seem a funny word for people, but it does feel like we're coming back to something each time. Anyway, so thank you all for showing up and practicing. And yeah, I just did want to say another little thing about the Dharmachakra, because Dharmachakra, they are not only just Buddhist Center Online, and they've also been doing free Buddhist audio. And I think that we were having this conversation, I think they're the oldest Tri Ratna, charity organization probably. And they've been here for years and years and years, even right back when I was doing Mitra study, and we had these tapes, and we had to sort of, each week somebody had a master tape and had to make all these copies of tapes so that people could hear Sangharakshita's talks. And then they had the CDs that they produced, and then they've done all the stuff on Free Buddhist Audio, and they've always made teachings and talks available. And I think really came into their own during the pandemic, when so many of us were in lockdown or, you know, not able to go in person to groups or to Buddhist centers, and really making the Dharma available for all of us all around the world. I think they help bring together the wider Sangha, the international Sangha, and give us a lot of opportunities to come across teachings and teachers and talks and retreats that we might never have come across otherwise. A great resource. And they do it with relatively little money and got a great team. So, and I know how hard it is, you know, so if you are able to now or later make a donation to them, they're not necessarily the most sexy appeal, but I think they're one of the ones that really hold us together as a community, as a spiritual community. Anyway, enough of that. So, yeah, just pausing a minute to think. Well, it is coming to the end of the retreat. And I would like just to say that endings are important. Transitions are important always, but especially endings. And I think especially endings when you've been on an online retreat, because if you were at an in-person retreat, probably you'd have traveled quite a way to get to the retreat center venue, and then you'd have a whole journey back that could be part of that transition. Whereas when you're doing a Zoom retreat, literally the moment we end and you switch off the Zoom room, you're right back in whatever your situation is, around whichever the people you are, back in your life. You might not have an easy transition, so just maybe be conscious about that, and if you can, be a bit quieter over the next few days. If you can be a bit more kind, tender towards yourself, that would help. We've been trying to cultivate that, haven't we, being aware and being kind and accepting and allowing. Can we keep that up once we leave the retreat? And also, just, you know, everything that we've been doing on the retreat, it's not just about meditation, it's about life, you know. So can you listen to yourself, find your voice? Can you, you know, connect with who you are deep down, what's most important to you? And can we allow ourselves to be how we are, align ourselves with reality, you know? And those worlds, those two worlds, the inner world, the outer world, coming together all the time through our experience, whatever that may be, our sense experience, our physical experience, whatever's happening in our hearts and minds, is happening, experiences happening in the world all the time. And we can bring kindness and awareness to that. And if we can loosen and soften on some of that desire, that craving for us to be other than we are, for the world to be other than we are, and just be with what is, not taking dukkha personally, in a way, accepting impermanence in our own experience and in the world around us, Well, maybe that will help a little bit of that transition. And there was a lot about, can we relax, you know, so that we're not always coming from that ego part of ourselves that's very self-concerned and wants to be in control and fix things. I came across a couple of lines Sangwetch had from the Bodhisattva ideal about fear and fearlessness. And I thought it was quite interesting that he said, fearlessness in the highest sense of the term is unattainable by material means. Fear, being essentially fear for oneself, can be overcome only with the elimination of the ego sense. That's interesting, isn't it? We can only get rid of fear if we let go of that ego sense. I have to test that out, see whether it works, but I did think that was interesting. And I just thought, yes, before we move into the main body of it, okay, also came across a Dilgo Khyentse Rinpoche quote, which felt very in tune with some of the things Paramahansa has just been saying. To feel overflowing love and almost unbearable compassion for all living creatures is the best way to fulfill the wishes of all the Buddhas and Bodhisattvas. Even if for a moment you cannot actually help a sentient being in an external way, meditate on love and compassion. Meditate on love and compassion constantly over the months and years until the compassion is knit inseparably into the very fabric of your mind. So meditate on love and compassion constantly over the months and years until the compassion is knit inseparably into the very fabric of your mind. And I guess that's one of the things about practice, isn't it? You do it again and again and again and again, and it becomes sort of second nature, your default way of being. And if we do enough practicing of mindfulness, kindness, compassion, equanimity, that'll become more and more our default, more and more how we are. We'll become more and more like the Buddhas and Bodhisattvas, and allowing our Buddha nature to develop and blossom. So we're now going to move into an evening of practice. So as I said, we're going to start with a Padmasambhava mantra. And then we're going to have a period of quietness, reflection, with me just dropping in some quotes from Padmasambhava. And at the end, we'll have another Padmasambhava mantra. Then we'll have the leg stretch, and then we'll just have a Sevenfold puja. So if you just want to get yourselves comfortable, Om Hum Vajraguru Padma Siddhi Hum. 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 Om Hum Vajraguru Padma Siddhi Hum.
Amma Om Vajraguru Padma Siddhi Om. 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 Om 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 Om Vajraguru Padma Siddhi Om.
Disposing yourself to be physically calm, as in an empty house the raindrops slowly gather, relax. Do not force your mind or body. Take measure of your wandering thoughts and, steady as Mount Meru, enter into meditation. Saying there are obstacles will get you nowhere. Do what you can at the time. Let these three expressions, I do not have, I do not understand, I do not know, be repeated over and over again. That is the heart of my advice. During the period of meditation, there is not anything. It is simply open. Since allowing thoughts to be just as they are, without trying to do anything with them, is sufficient, how can you say that you are not able to do anything with regard to them? in terms of your own mind, as is the case with everyone, samsara and nirvana are inseparable. Nonetheless, because you persist in accepting and enduring attachments and aversions, you will continue to wander in samsara. As anything can happen, peace will arise from within. Okay, so we'll have about a 5 minute break and then come back for Sevenfold Puja. Okay. So, final Sevenfold Puja. And let's not take the puja for granted. It is a practice. It is a practice that, as I said, is a preliminary practice for the arising of the bodhicitta. And if we're doing devotional practice and meditation practice and ethical practice and we're cultivating wisdom, all those things will help us along the way. And we've been talking quite a lot around that idea of Buddha nature, haven't we? Getting back to our Buddha nature. I had Hakuin, yeah, song of meditation, all beings from the very beginning are Buddhas. And while it is true that without living beings, no Buddhas, just because we're there and we've got Buddha nature doesn't mean that we are Buddhas. So Padmasambhava was quite clear about the need for practice. So I'm going to read it before we start, and then we'll read it again before the Heart Sutta, just as a reminder about the need for practice. So just as in the case with the sesame seed being the cause of the oil and milk being the cause of butter, but where the oil is not obtained without pressing, and the butter is not obtained without churning, so all sentient beings, even though they possess the actual essence of Buddhahood, will not realize Buddhahood without engaging in practice. So we've been doing a lot of practice all week, and we're about to engage in some more. So here we go. Sevenfold puja. Firstly, worship. With Mandarava, blue lotus, and jasmine.
With Mandarava, blue lotus, and jasmine.
With all flowers pleasing and fragrant.
With all flowers pleasing and fragrant.
And with garlands skillfully woven.
And with garlands skillfully woven.
I pay honour to the princes of the sages.
I pay honour to the princes of the sages.
So worthy of veneration.
So worthy of veneration.
I envelop them in clouds of incense.
I envelop them in clouds of incense.
Sweet and penetrating.
Sweet and penetrating.
I make them offerings of food, hard and soft.
I make them offerings of food, hard and soft.
And pleasing kinds of liquids to drink.
And pleasing kinds of liquids to drink.
I offer them lamps encrusted with jewels.
I offer them lamps encrusted with jewels.
Festooned with golden lotus.
Festooned with golden lotus.
On the paving sprinkled with perfume.
On the paving sprinkled with perfume.
I scatter handfuls of beautiful flowers.
I scatter handfuls of beautiful flowers.
Om Tare, Tu Tare Ture Swaha. 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 Om Tare, Tu
Tutare ture swaha. Om tare. 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 Tutare ture swaha.
Salutation. As many atoms as there are,
as many atoms as there are,
in the thousand million worlds,
in the thousand million worlds,
so many times I make reverent salutation,
so many times I make reverent salutation,
to all the Buddhas in the three eras,
to all the Buddhas in the three eras,
to the Siddharma,
to the Siddharma,
and to the excellent community,
and to the excellent community.
I pay homage to all the shrines,
I pay homage to all the shrines,
and places in which the Bodhisattvas have been,
and places in which the Bodhisattvas have been.
I make profound obeisance to the teachers,
I make profound obeisance to the teachers,
and those to whom respectful salutation is due,
and those to whom respectful salutation is due.
Going for refuge. This very day,
this very day,
I go for my refuge,
I go for my refuge,
to the powerful protectors,
to the powerful protectors,
whose purpose is to guard the universe,
whose purpose is to guard the universe,
the mighty conquerors who overcome suffering everywhere,
the mighty conquerors who overcome suffering everywhere.
Wholeheartedly also I take my refuge,
wholeheartedly also I take my refuge,
in the Dharma they have ascertained,
in the Dharma they have ascertained,
which is the abode of security against the rounds of rebirth,
which is the abode of security against the rounds of rebirth.
Likewise in the host of Bodhisattvas,
likewise in the host of Bodhisattvas,
I take my refuge,
I take my refuge.
Namo tassa bhagavato arahato samma sambuddhassa. Namo tassa bhagavato arahato samma sambuddhassa. Namo tassa bhagavato arahato samma sambuddhassa. Buddhaṃ saraṇaṃ gacchāmi, dhammaṃ saraṇaṃ gacchāmi, sanghaṃ saraṇaṃ gacchāmi. Dutiyampi buddhaṃ saraṇaṃ gacchāmi, dutiyampi dhammaṃ saraṇaṃ gacchāmi, dutiyampi sanghaṃ saraṇaṃ gacchāmi, tatiyampi buddhaṃ saraṇaṃ gacchāmi, tatiyampi dhammaṃ saraṇaṃ gacchāmi, Tachyampi Sanghang Saranang Gacchami Panatipata Veramani Sikapadam Samadhyami Adinadana Veramani Sikapadam Samadhyami Kamesu Vichachara Veramani Sikapadam Samadhyami Musavada Veramani Sikapadam Samadhyami Suramariya Vajja Pamadatana Veramani Sikapadam Samadhyami Sadhu Sadhu Sadhu.
With deeds of loving kindness, I purify my body. With open-handed generosity, I purify my body. With stillness, simplicity, and contentment, I purify my body. With truthful communication, I purify my speech. With mindfulness clear and radiant, I purify my mind. Confession of faults. The evil that I have heaped up,
the evil that I have heaped up,
through my ignorance and foolishness,
through my ignorance and foolishness,
evil in the world of everyday experience,
evil in the world of everyday experience,
as well as evil in understanding and intelligence,
as well as evil in understanding and intelligence,
all that I acknowledge to the protectors,
all that I acknowledge to the protectors,
standing before them,
standing before them,
with hands raised in reverence,
with hands raised in reverence,
and terrified of suffering,
and terrified of suffering,
I pay salutations again and again,
I pay salutations again and again.
May the leaders receive this kindly,
may the leaders receive this kindly.
May the leaders receive this kindly.
May the leaders receive this kindly.
Just as it is with its many faults.
Just as it is with its many faults.
What is not good, O protectors?
What is not good, O protectors?
I shall not do again.
I shall not do again.
Rejoicing in merit. I rejoice with delight.
I rejoice with delight.
In the good done by all beings.
In the good done by all beings.
Through which they obtain rest.
Through which they obtain rest.
With the end of suffering.
With the end of suffering.
May those who have suffered be happy.
May those who have suffered be happy.
I rejoice in the release of beings.
I rejoice in the release of beings.
From the sufferings of the rounds of existence.
From the sufferings of the rounds of existence.
I rejoice in the nature of the Bodhisattva.
I rejoice in the nature of the Bodhisattva.
And the Buddha.
And the Buddha.
Who are protectors.
Who are protectors.
I rejoice in the arising of the will to enlightenment.
I rejoice in the arising of the will to enlightenment.
And the teaching.
And the teaching.
Those oceans that bring happiness to all beings.
Those oceans that bring happiness to all beings.
And are the abode of welfare of all beings.
And are the abode of welfare of all beings.
Entreaty and supplication. Saluting them with folded hands.
Saluting them with folded hands.
I entreat the Buddhas in all the quarters.
I entreat the Buddhas in all the quarters.
May they make shine the lamp of the Dharma.
May they make shine the lamp of the Dharma.
For those wandering in the suffering of delusion.
For those wandering in the suffering of delusion.
With hands folded in reverence.
With hands folded in reverence.
I implore the conquerors desiring to enter Nirvana.
I implore the conquerors desiring to enter Nirvana.
May they remain here for endless ages.
May they remain here for endless ages.
So that life in this world does not grow dark.
So that life in this world does not grow dark.
Just as is the case with the sesame seed being the cause of the oil and milk being the cause of butter, but where the oil is not obtained without pressing and the butter is not obtained without churning, so all sentient beings, even though they possess the actual essence of Buddhahood, will not realize Buddhahood without engaging in practice. The Heart Sutra in unison. The Bodhisattva of compassion,
when he meditated deeply,
saw the emptiness of all five skandhas
and sundered
the bonds that caused him suffering. Here then, form is no other than emptiness, emptiness no other than form. Form is only emptiness, emptiness only form. Feeling, thought, and choice, consciousness itself,
are the same as this.
All things are by nature void. They are not born or destroyed, nor are they stained or pure, nor do they wax or wane.
So,
in emptiness, no form. No feeling, thought, or choice, nor is there consciousness. No eye, ear, nose, tongue, body, mind. No color, sound, smell, taste, touch, or what the mind takes hold of, nor even act of sensing. No ignorance,
or
end of it, nor all that comes of ignorance, no withering, no death, no end of them, nor is there pain or cause of pain, or cease in pain, or noble path to lead from pain. Not even wisdom to attain. Attainment too is emptiness. So know that the Bodhisattva, holding to nothing whatever, but dwelling in pranya wisdom, is freed of delusive hindrance, rid of the fear bred by it, and reaches clearest nirvana. All Buddhas of past and present, Buddhas of future time, using this pranya wisdom, come to full and perfect vision. Hear then the great Dharani, the radiant peerless mantra, the pranya paramita, whose words allay all pain. Hear and believe its truth. Gate gate paragate arasangate bodhisvaha. Gate gate paragate parasangate bodhisvaha. Gate gate paragate parasangate bodhisvaha. Transference of merit and self-surrender. May the merit gained,
may the merit gained
in my acting thus,
in my acting thus,
go to the alleviation of the suffering of all beings.
Go to the alleviation of the suffering of all beings.
My personality throughout my existences.
My personality throughout my existences.
My possessions.
My possessions.
And my merit in all three ways.
And my merit in all three ways.
I give up without regard to myself.
I give up without regard to myself.
For the benefit of all beings.
For the benefit of all beings.
Just as the earth and other elements,
just as the earth and other elements
are serviceable in many ways,
are serviceable in many ways
to the infinite number of beings,
to the infinite number of beings
inhabiting limitless space,
inhabiting limitless space,
so may I become,
so may I become
that which maintains all beings,
that which maintains all beings.
So long as all have not attained,
so long as all have not attained
to peace,
to peace.
Om Tare Tu Tare Tu Re Swaha. 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 Om Tare Tu Tare Tu Re
Swaha. Om Tare Tu Tare Tu E 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 Swaha.
Om Mani Padme Hum.
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 Om Arapajanadi.
Om Arapajanadi.
Om Arapajanadi.
Om Arapajanadi.
Om Arapajanadi.
Om Arapajanadi.
Om Vajrapani Hum.
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 Om Tare Tu Tare Tu Re Swaha.
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 Om Tare Tu Tare Tu Re Swaha. Gate, par gate, par sangache bodhi svaha.
Om shanti.
Om shanti.
Shanti.
So thank you all very much, not just for coming along this evening, but for being here for the whole retreat and helping to create this really lovely spiritual community we've had on the retreat. So go well, take care, and hope to see you again somewhere, somehow. But we're all interconnected anyway, so it doesn't matter.